Hi guys, welcome back to the Unknown Journey YouTube channel. Today episode of our motor farm build, I'm going to show you how I pouring the cylinder head. This is gonna be fun job and also it's take time. All right, let's get to work. The tool I use is the air grinder. The burr by bit, this is the long one, so I can reach deep in the port. I have the short one to cut the valve seat. This for the steel, and this for the aluminum. And also I have the sand roll, so for the polish. Don't forget the goggle. You have to protect your eye. A lot of the aluminum shaving gonna be shooting out, so be fast. On the intake valve seat, I remove 1/3 of the inner side of the seat. So this will make the size of the hole is bigger. So that means it's gonna be increased more airflow through it. Thank you.
intake port, a lot of meat is being removed and the size look big, and that's how I want it. Also look at the valve guide, I shaping it down, now it look flush with the surface. It's okay to cut the valve guide that far. I've been trying to run it into my car and it's no problem. This will be the last part of the job. I'm not gonna show you the other three because it's just repeat step. It's just like boring, you know, and then I just show you one because all of it will be the same. And also on the exhaust side, it's also be the same. So right now, I gonna, you know, trimming some of the edges and make sure it's like smooth enough for the polish. Next step, I'm going to get the whole head clean up and then do the polish and do the valve lapping and very much. That's be it. Day two. Yesterday, I got very much basic cutting all the ports, remove all the meat to increase the size of the port, and also flattening out all the valve guide. I do some polish. The last one, I'm not done on the polish yet, but the other three is already done. So now I'm gonna show you a little bit about how I polish it. So I have the sand roll right here, basically, which is the on the exhaust side, I also remove a lot of meat. You can see the size of the exhaust is also look very big. And also the valve guide is been cutting down. On the valve lapping job, we're not gonna lap the use the new valve to lap them. What I do is I use the stock valve, same way on the intake and exhaust. You can use only one valve, and you use the valve grinding compound, and you keep lapping them. or A of the intake, and also on the exhaust, or A on the exhaust. Come down when you can see the seat. The surfaces look nice and clean. So that way when you install the new valve, that's be able to seal it. On the valve lapping, you put the grinding compound. Make sure it's not too much. Just enough. Just enough. I use a cordless drill to attach to the bottom of the valve, and that's how we lapping it. Continue to do this until you got all of it nice and clean. So what you do is after you lapping it, and then you clean it, you take a look at the valve seat. If the surface just look nice and clean, that's good to go. So you will continue to do all of it as the same. So that's how you do your valve lapping job.
Day two of the K-Series head porting job. I have the intake side and also the exhaust side all port and polished. Next video, I hope I can show you how I dimble it, because that step is kind of take longer. I have the valve lapping job also done. And now I'm waiting on the valve spring and retainer and do the valve and spring assemble, and that's it. This cylinder head is ready to rock. This video is to show you the idea that's how I pointing the cylinder head. I hope this will be helpful. You can do it yourself. We don't have a big equipment to do it. That's why we have to do it by hand. Well, that's be all for today's video. Thank you for watching, and I will see you guys next time.